What's up, guys? This is probably the video I'm most excited about because we finally get to start painting. I believe we're at part 5. I'll correct myself if I'm wrong. Sorry, I'm doing stuff behind the camera right now. Part 5 of the Joust Restore. If you remember last time, the battery was dying as I was doing the finishing touches. I finished up the Bondo. It looks like garbage, but it's actually smooth. I sanded it again today. On the sides, I spray painted the coin door and the, I guess that's the coin lockbox door, or whatever you want to call it. And this line here, focus, was actually about a, I don't know, like a 2 millimeter gash. Probably somebody moving it, the machine the day, caught a corner or something and just snagged it. So I did a light thing at Bondo here, just kind of smooth this out. So hopefully that doesn't pop through. That didn't do anything there. And then in prep work, I just kind of did another light sand and cleaned it up with a cleaning pad just to get all the dust off. But yeah, I'm actually kind of excited just for having this thing standing up instead of on its back. I'm so used to just looking at it every time I come over to the garage, just laying on its side. So let's slap some primer on this bad boy and see what it looks like. Before we get started, the reason we're priming is there's actually a whole crap ton of paint on here, but I want to prime it just so that the Bondo texture doesn't come through and look a little bit different. So I'm just trying to make it one even plane of color, if you will. But, and what else can I state before we get started? Primer, just whatever primer I found at Walmart. 123 primer for all surfaces. Sticks to all surfaces without sanding. Well, sanded anyway. Seals uniformly, blocks stains, dries in an hour. Used with any top coat. So it was like 10 bucks. And then this I got at Walmart as well. Gloss leather brown. I tried matching the original brown with a sample, but it ended up coming out too light. And then I found this just passing through the paint aisle that it looked more what I was trying to go for than the thing I tried to match. So that's actually another cheap can of, is this oil-based? Protective, yeah, this is oil. Well, most people say to stay away from latex. It probably doesn't matter, it's paint. This might stay on a little bit longer. And then I got two different types of rollers to see what's gonna work best. This foam roller and this, fuzzy roller. They probably got fancy names, but whatever. Hey, it's me from the future. This roller actually works better as far as getting an even coat, more so than the thicker, fatter roller. So FYI, back to the future, foam and fuzzy. So, without further ado, let's prime this bitch.
What's up, guys? Now we have a brown painted Joust empty arcade cabinet. So you know what that means. It's time to apply the stencil, which I've effing had a difficult time trying to get out of the tube. So I actually left, I did this yesterday, I left it out overnight to acclimate to the whatever temperature, and just to kind of flatten it out. I put some weights at the end, just make it a little bit easier when I go to apply the stencil. And so what's going to happen is I'm just going to set up the tripod just so you guys can see the whole process. I looked through YouTube, I couldn't find anything as far as applying a stencil, so hopefully I'm doing this correctly. I don't know, if anything, it'll show you guys what not to do if I mess it up. But hopefully it's it goes well and I can help everybody out. So I'm just going to set the tripod up, and I'll probably interrupt if I like notice anything out of the ordinary. But the plan is we're going to take the stencil. It has like an adhesive back to it. So we're going to apply it to this guy. But before we peel off the adhesive back, I'm actually going to tape it up with some just masking tape. That way it's not like, I mean, I don't know how sticky this stuff is. I don't want it to be like permanently attached and I put it on crooked or upside down and I'm like, oh shit, now I need to go redo it. That way I can just work pretty much from the top down. So, a little nervous, first time doing this. Yeah, let's see what happens. Wish me luck.
We'll be right back. Alright, so I had to take an X-Acto knife because the paint was peeling up as I was removing the stencil. But I did some research. Actually, this is like 2 days since I've started filming this. I did some research online. I took the stencil way too early. I had a fan on it for like 25 minutes, and I told people that online. They're like, whoa, what the hell are you doing? That's not how you do the stencil. You actually have to leave it on for about 24 hours so that the paint actually cures to the paint underneath. So I did that with the other side, and it was like night and day. Actually, well, now you can't see because I covered up the second part of the stencil, but the stencil came up fine. The lines look great. I just kind of botched it on the first color, but luckily I salvaged it. It just took a little time to X-Acto it out. I mean, and then I let it sit for, like I said, like 2 days. So this is now hopefully bonded to the outside paint. So if you are doing this stencil, put, also I think I did too much paint the first time too, because I did a lesser coat on the other side, and it looks just as good, and it just came out better. So light coat of paint, leave it on for 24 hours overnight, and then remove the stencil. Yeah, okay, so let's put the stencil on this side.
Okay, so I took the white. Actually, my camera died before I put the white paint on, or the ivory paint on. So I put that on and removed that stencil, and this side actually came out really decent, except for some of my brown paint came off, which I really don't understand since I put on two coats of primer. So I'm gonna have to do some touch-ups here. It actually pulled the primer and the brown off because that's the original shitty black latex that was under the bottom. And I got some little flaking down here. I'll just touch up with a small paintbrush. So yeah, this side came out pretty decent. The other side, which is the first side that I did with the gold on, not so hot. You can see it started taking up some of the yellow. A lot more touch-up work here. And if you look, oh wow, even left the residue from the stencil. I don't know what the hell. I mean, I left this on longer than 24 hours for the gold to cure before I put the ivory stencil on. And I don't understand why I did that. So this side sucks, but it does come off. If you just rub the shit out of it, it does come off. And I read online that WD-40 will actually get some adhesive off without ruining the paint. I mean, at this point, the paint's already kind of effed up to begin with. So I'm gonna put the night stencil on because there's no sense in touching this up, putting on the night stencil, ripping that off, and then even more gold paint comes on or comes off. So look, there's even more. So yeah, I'm gonna put that on. Then I'm actually gonna tape up the other colors besides gold, exposing only what I need. I mean, it's not in a lot of places. It's 1, 2, the circle's kind of jacked up, 3, bird's ass, 4, and his big toe. Oh, and then right here, the fucking brown came off here too. But this one revealed the primer. It feels like paper. Yep, goddamn, more brown's coming up. So, hell, I don't know. More primer? The hell am I supposed to do? So, oh, and his back toe's all jacked up too. So after everything is all said, everything's all said and done, I think I'm gonna go back over the whole damn thing with some clear coat to prevent any additional peeling. This side's just a huge disappointment. Anyway, also I realized that I'm not showing you guys how to take this stencil off. I'll show you with this one tomorrow. It's actually 11 o'clock tonight. To let this one sit for 24 hours too. But let's say my battery dies again, I can't do it. The way you take the stencil off, you actually wanna you grab the corner to get it started, but when you peel the stencil off to help prevent the paint from ripping off with the stencil, you want to pull at like a 90 degree, like as sharp of an angle as you can. You don't want to like pull out like a what is that, 45? I don't know. You want to pull literally straight down with the as you're taking this off. So, but I'll show you that. Hopefully I charge my battery up, so we should be good. So now, I got this side lined up for the oh god, it shifted on me. For the most part, I gotta realign some crap. This one's matched up though. So how does one match but the other one doesn't? I don't know. So I'm gonna put the night on and then pick this video up tomorrow and see, hopefully this doesn't rip off my paint. All right.
Just to give you an idea of the exact colors I'm using, they're all Krylon. This is just shit you get from Walmart. Bauhaus Gold, Cherry Red, which I got because it was actually a deeper red instead of a brighter red. I didn't want like a candy apple red. Just a preference. And then Ivory, which is almost white, but not quite. It's like an off-white vanilla mish. And these colors aren't exactly 100% what the original Joust is, but it's close enough. Okay, so we got the red drying now, which, wow, it looks pretty wild through the camera. And who the hell is texting me at freaking midnight right now? Anywho, so yeah, we gotta let this dry overnight for 24 hours. And I don't think I'm gonna record me doing these touch-ups. It's just gonna be tedious bullshit work I gotta put together. I got this side going too. Also needs to dry. And I'm using this flashlight to see, because the lighting in here kind of sucks. So just to go along the outlines to make sure I didn't miss anything. Looks pretty straightforward. I did forget to take off the damn residue for where the Williams W is, so hopefully that doesn't come through. And then hopefully more yellow doesn't come off when I take this stencil off. Just be more touch-up work. So I don't know how the hell I'm actually gonna do. I guess I'll tape these up and just spray paint them again. Let me get this flashlight off. I don't know how well, I was debating on whether to just put like spray paint in a cup and then just using a brush to touch this up, but I don't know if that's how it's gonna work. I imagine it wouldn't work that way because it's a can spray paint, so who knows. Anyway, damn, who the hell is texting me? So, we'll pick this up tomorrow. Alright guys, so it's been 24 hours for the red paint to dry, cure, adhere, hopefully, yeah. It's, man, I'm having a hard time formulating thoughts. It's actually after midnight right now. So, I wanted to pull this off tonight so I could see if I need to do any touch-ups tomorrow. And I thought because I've been avoiding showing you guys how to pull off the stencil, just kind of a little bit of excited to get the thing done. I thought I'd film this one. So when you do take off the stencil, you just want to make sure that you pull down at like a 90 degree angle. That way you don't want to pull out because you risk pulling off some extra paint. So if you pull down at as sharp an angle as you can, you should avoid that. So let me show you what I'm talking about. Get rid of all this tape. Same thing with tape, you don't want to rip this stuff off too and chance ripping off paint. But I think there's tape, it shouldn't do it, so who knows. Just be cautious, I just don't like redoing it. And just take your time. scissors. Just make it a little more manageable. Bitchin'. Let me zoom out a little bit so you can see what the final product looks like. If I can speak. Jesus, I told you it was late. See what the final product looks like. And I'm pretty happy with it. There's if you get close, you can see some minor mistakes. These are registry marks. They're just guides to help you line the stencils up, but these just peel right off. If I can get my fingernail underneath of it. Come on, you bitch. Oh my god. Yeah, see, it just comes right off. If you can get it started. All right, so yeah, I think it looks good. I'm impressed with how it turned out, actually. I kind of wish I went with a little bit brighter red, or maybe I didn't put enough on. I mean, it looks fine. It looks more like medieval, like the wine red colors back then. I don't know.
But yeah, I'm effing stoked actually. So if you get up really close, let me show you guys. I probably shouldn't show you this and just make you think that I'm amazing and I didn't fuck up anything. Like you could see here, it's not a perfect line because some of the corners did come off whenever you remove the stencils. I don't know why. I don't know if it's the paint I used. Or like here. Jesus. Like it's not perfectly round here. So I'll probably go in with a small touch-up brush with some spray paint. Kind of just spray some spray paint in like a cup and just use it as if it wasn't, if it was just normal paint, and fix that stuff up. But I might not even do that because this looks fine to me. I mean, you guys saw what it looked like before. Jesus Christ, this is night and day compared to what we were working with. And like some, it's not gonna be perfect. But, I mean, when you stand back from here, that looks like a brand new arcade cabinet. So, I'm pretty stoked. The other side, I have yet to take off yet, but I did start doing some touch-up work down here by the foot, which if you look at it dead on, you probably can't see it. Well, you can kind of, well, here's like where the paint was chipping up. This was all white, actually. It exposed the primer underneath. I gotta fix this. This is a toenail, hoof, whatever. The Achilles tendon. I don't even know what the hell body parts are on this creature. But whatever these things are, I need to fill them up. But it's mostly just the yellow. I don't think any of the white or ivory color came up at all. Some of the brown did come up. And I think there's actually underneath the stencil, there's even more brown that got ripped up. And I'm not looking forward to taking this side off because I know it's just going to rip off more paint. But at least I can show you guys a good side. And I think we're going to end on this note. Painting is complete. We got the side done. The front coin door and everything I redid. Oh, Jesus, there's so much. Let me show you all the trash that I'm working with. This is all just from the stencil. This pile right here. That pile. All over the place. And I'm walking all over it, getting stuck to my shoe. I'm tracking in the house. Oh, look, there's another pile. So it's a big mess. Lots of paper, lots of adhesive, lots of tape. So keep that in mind. So yeah, this is painted. I painted the back black, painted the top black. I gotta get some kind of like mesh material going here that you can, well, you can't see. Well, yeah, you kind of see from this angle. I'll get some from the light. You see like this, there you go. It's like a mesh plastic. I guess it ran across the inside of this. Yeah, you can actually feel it all the way around. I guess somebody's poked their hand through it. I don't know. But, yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do here. I'll probably just leave it alone. It's not like it's hurting anything. Just make it more complete than it already is. I definitely have to dust. When you spray paint, I just spit on myself. When you spray paint, you're gonna get a lot of like spray paint dust everywhere. Like you can see my floor is yellow right now. That's actually not paint. I can sweep that up. It's just leftover residue. So yeah, I think tonight before I go to bed, I'm going to finish this touch-ups. And then our next video, what are we going to do in the next video? We got to do T-molding. You know what? Maybe we'll put the control panel in. We'll finish the rest of the aesthetics, if you will. We'll do the marquee, get that guy in. I need to cut another piece of plexiglass. I decided to, over top of the one we got. T-molding, we'll put the control panel in, and we'll change out some blocks. And, you know, I guess we could put the, what's your dealie on? What the hell is this called? Jeez, I told you, it's late. I'm running like 4 hours of sleep right now. Bezel, Christ, why can't I think of things right now?
Yeah, because I think we can put the monitor in from the backside. Excuse me. If I open this up. Oh, yeah, that's plenty of room to put the monitor in. So we don't even need to work in from the inside. So, yeah, I think we'll put it together as if it's really working. I mean, there's going to be no monitor. But from afar, it's going to look like a complete Joust machine. And then we have to redo the monitor. We have to cap, put all the capacitors. I bought a cap kit for that. Where's this guy at? Over here in my... Well, there's my bathroom. One of my bathrooms. Here's the corner where all the old tubes go. That are usually missing chassis or burned up chassis. These two actually work. The one in the far back actually came... That was actually came out of my first arcade machine and that was turned into a main machine, which is now the Neo Geo. Oh, it's all the way on the other side. But, yeah, that came out of there and I just never had a use for it. But I kept it. It's got some Pac-Man burn on it. I don't know what to do with it. But anyway, this is the original monitor that came out of the Joust machine, which was a 10-yard fight when I picked it up. And I remember, so the 10-yard fight worked when we did pick it up, except the monitor was all... It had jacked up colors, it was crooked, it was shaky, it had a lot of issues. So, I just decided to get a cap kit to fix what's going on. And hopefully we might have to rejuve the tube, but hopefully the tube is fine. But if not, I'll show you guys how to do that. I have a tool that's actually that little black box right there on top of the wooden box that essentially sends a... electricity through the tube to clean the color guns or jets or whatever they're called. But yeah, I can show you that if that is the case. You know, I probably should do a video on that anyway, just because it's a good... If you have a bunch of arcades, it's definitely a good tool to get tube rejuvenator. You can pick them up on eBay. And, so yeah, anyway. What else? New pickup over there, which is going to be a separate video, which I probably shouldn't have just showed you. Keep it a surprise. Oh, Fix the Felix, I think it's going to be next, followed by Bosconian. Yeah, it might be done in parallel. I haven't decided yet. I'm just tired of spending money. What else? You know, I think that's it for now. Oh, then we have to wire up the cabinet. Why am I forgetting the most important part? We got to put a game in this eventually, right? So I have the game board. I have the power supply. I have the buttons. I have the switches. We have everything for the game. Right now it's just finding time to put it all together. And I'm pretty sure that works. Actually, I found the... Laying around by the monitor, I found the wiring harness that went to the light. So, I just gotta tie that into the power supply. And, yeah. So, yeah. I apologize if this ending of the video is a little dry and dull. I'm falling asleep as I'm filming it. And, but yeah, I think we, this is a good way to end this video. Alright, guys. Well, then, next time, we will finish doing the physical attributes, aesthetics. Making it look pretty. Whatever. I'm going to bed. All right, guys. I'll see you next time. Later.